Welcome to tonight's game. It promises to be a good one between the Virginia Cavaliers and the NC Greensboro Spartans. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our star watch for today's game. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Two talented young men are featured at the power forward spot. They usually play hard and play well, so keep an eye on them.
All right, guys are in position, and we're ready for the tip. And after all the anticipation, we're underway. Inside. Puts up the J. Off the glass and no good. And we've got a change in possession here. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Both teams are looking to get something going here.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Open shot. He swishes it from downtown. Moving it around the perimeter.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Paul handles the feed. And up, and it's good.
Inside.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. You know, Brad, as a coach, your seniors are a very important part of their operation. The underclassmen look up to them and really lean on them for guidance and direction. When a senior accepts this role and leads by example, it helps the coaching staff and the team immensely. Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Oh, this man's in trouble. Baldwin picks up the foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Zone offense now. Way out on the right wing. Fires away. And come up short. They work it around the perimeter. Oh, that's charging.
Great defense, Brad.
Number 22 gets in on the action for the first time tonight.
He has a great presence when he steps on the floor, Brad.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Trying to pack it inside with the fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Off the mark. Braswell receives the ball. On the outside. Puts up the jumper. Knocked it down.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Got the high pick. Looks at a three. Jumper won't go. Gave it up. Tries for two. It's good. He can put points up and he can move the ball.
It doesn't matter if you're a scorer who passes well or a good passer who can score. There will always be a spot for you on a team.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block for the bucket. That was nice. Braswell receives the pass. Inside. He tries the jumper. Missed the jumper. Feed the low post. Number 22 is called for the foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Well, here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. With your underclassmen, it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
He hits a second. They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
No good. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Trying to feed inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. Can't connect. Are some of the things that up-tempo teams will look to do, Dick?
Up-tempo teams really want to put pressure on a defense. They want to create tempo in the game, and they want the tempo to be at a high pace.
They work it around the perimeter. Ten seconds. Number 11 is whistled for the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Opportunity now for an easy one. First one is no good. Second one is no good. Number 32 takes the feed. For two, he hits it. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Out on the wing. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Number 32 with the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy baskets.
Well, I'm not sure this is the guy you want to send to the free throw line.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. He values these looks. A good opportunity to put points on the board.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Cross court.
He's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Can't get the long jumper. Would have been good for three. On the dribble, gives it up. From the corner. And we're going the other way. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
He goes up with it. Off the mark.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
And a momentary look from three-point land for the bucket. He gets the bucket to fall.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Two. That one's off. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
In the lane. The missed shot. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the top of the circle.
Jumping didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Off the mark. The point guard takes the pass. Unloads a three. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. For the bucket. He makes the shot. Gave it up. Top of the circle. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
He puts up the J. Scorches the net with a J. Looking for a good shot. And we're at the 8-minute mark. Out on the right wing. He shoots from the deep corner. Nope. For two. He can't get the hoop to fall. Up and come up short. They work the perimeter. He shoots from the corner. Off the mark. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Wilkins receives the ball. Missed it. Dickard's zone susceptible to the jumper?
Yeah, only if the rotation is late on D, Brad.
About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. now trying to feed the low block, and his shot rejected. Off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up with a shot. They're having a real tough time hitting from the floor.
They couldn't hit the ocean with a beach ball right now, Brad. That was some of my players. That's why I got fired. What an embarrassment.
He attempts the jump shot. Busts the J. On the outside. About 6 minutes remaining. Rejected. His shot's blocked.
Hey, he thought he spotted space in that zone, but not today, baby.
For the bucket, he gets the shot to fall. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
Doing a wonderful job putting the ball on the floor and getting into the painted area.
Out on the wing. For two. Nice shot. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
They're working around the arc. He shoots from the top of the circle. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
We're at the 5 minute mark. Goes up for two. Can't put it down. Braswell receives the pass.
Look at that spacing.
Tries for two. He nails the bucket. They look to get it to the inside. He pulls up with a jumper. Scores it. Now they work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Gets it to fall.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled him to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, Brad, you look at your juniors as third-year players who have been there. Nothing should be new to them by the time they're in their third season. They should know what's expected from them in the classroom, and they should know what to expect from their conference opponents. The level of familiarity should be much higher than what it was in their first year.
He makes the second. Number 30 looks to record his first minutes.
He provides nice push offensively and defensively for this bunch.
Well, this man's in trouble. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
That goes out of bounds, and we'll stay at this end. Moving it around the perimeter. Jumper can't connect. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Two teams who are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
Dumps it in. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Jumper won't go. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. three ball, nails the jumper. Gave it up. He shoots the jumper. Off the mark.
There it is, Jam City. Up and inside.
The skip pass is picked off. Now in transition. They work it around the perimeter. If you call for it, he may throw it to you, too. Let's take another look at this dunk.
Hey, look at him hammer this one down. Send a message, young man. Send a message.
They're set to throw it in from the side. On the outside. For two. Nope. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. With the fadeaway, off the glass and no good. He buries it. Momentary look from three-point land. Let's watch the move as he works his man and not a fadeaway jumper. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Goes up for two. Great shot. 1 minute left to go. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Missed the jumper. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He tries the jumper. They got it. They had the ball moving all over the place there, Dick.
You know, that's how you draw them up. It's so important that the ball moves from one side of the court to the other. So important when you attack it offensively. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
He had to hurry that one. Off the mark. The Spartans are behind by three. Well, let's take a look at our game summary to this point so far, Dick.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Makes the substitution back into the ballgame.
Well, Brad, it's going to be interesting to see what kind of energy he comes with.
For that reason right there, that's why I love college basketball.
This place is rocking.
Blocked. Baldwin handles the feed. Cross court. Tries for two. Off the mark. Let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
The Spartans talked about hitting the offensive glass during halftime. This was a point of emphasis, which they basically ignored in the first half. Look for them to start sending four or five players to the boards with hopes of getting an offensive putback. It may be a risky play at this point, but they must make a move. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Missed it. looking for a good shot with a deep shot from outside. Gets the J to fall. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Bucket off the glass and no good. Number 11 receives the ball. Here's a double team for two. Off the glass and no good. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. Nickel saves it. Turnover committed by the senior. On the left side. Goes up for two. Gets it to go.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. You betcha. They move it into the front court. Turns it over. Cross court.
Turnover committed by the senior.
On the left side. Looking for a good shot. Shoots it. Perfectly executed. There they come with a double team to stop it. For three. Scores it. They work the perimeter. Takes the jumper and come up short. Braswell handles the pass.
Double team now, bad angle.
Number 11 is charged with the foul. Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
Cross court. For the bucket. He hits the shot. The Spartans got some good ball reversal there.
Hey, I'm so impressed with the offensive execution. Beautiful ball movement. The ball reversals are getting them some great, great looks.
On the outside. For two. Off the glass and no good. The shooting guard gets the ball. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. The fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Work it around the arc. Goes up for two. Drains it.
Look at that spacing.
It's not smart to just throw it out of bounds. The Cavaliers have been getting it done tonight in a lot of different ways.
I tell you, it can really cause a defense fits and throw you off on offense when a team can play strong across all five positions on the floor.
Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two, struggles with a close one. Number 32 gets the ball.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He misses the fadeaway. Moving it around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper. Can't connect. Number 11 takes the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. The crowd starting to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage? Up and inside.
For the bucket, he gets it to fall. Trying to pack it inside, goes up with it, nails a sweet jumper. They work it around the perimeter. For two, buried it. On the outside, he takes a three, missed the jumper. Braswell handles the feed. They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Got it.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. He shoots. They can't find the range right now behind the arc.
They should start looking elsewhere, maybe try and get an easy one inside. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Puts up the J. The missed shot. The shooting guard takes the pass. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He shows the sweet touch. Looking for a good shot.
Hit it.
Tries for two. Well, he'll want that one back.
Good rebound. Great position on the rebound. Could block out. They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Sinks it. Looking to move it around the perimeter. The Spartans have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. Working it around the perimeter. The turn of fadeaway jumper. Jumper won't go. Look at that student body. They are going mad.
They look like they're having a blast.
Time to pick up the defense here now. And the ball out of bounds, but we'll be staying right here. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
It seems like he's everywhere at once. He's been making good decisions and been strong with the ball. The coach has got to be happy with his performance so far.
they'll inbound on the near sideline. Looking for a good shot.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
They're having a real tough time hitting from the floor.
You know what their problem is, Brad? They aren't shooting the ball with confidence. They're just throwing it up there, hoping and praying that it goes in. And that's not going to get it done.
Around 8 minutes remaining. Let's take another look at our star watch. Braswell checks in the game again.
Hey, always interesting to see how players respond after a bit of a breather.
They work the perimeter. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
The point guard receives the ball on the outside. Number 32 with the projected out of there.
Nice block shot.
The Spartans might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. I think it's time to ditch any default strategy in hopes of getting some quick baskets and some easy scores.
Hey, the clock nor the score is in their favor. They're going to have to switch up their style and play completely up-tempo. They should be looking to press and score quickly, Brad.
About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. He tries the three ball.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. And that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. There is no play that includes that guy in the stands. He can't get any more open than that. Nails the J. The Cavaliers should consider switching their current tempo and mindset to more of a half-court game. With the time and score on their side, that seems to make sense to me, Dick.
Preserving the lead should be the primary focus. Continuing to play an up-tempo game wouldn't be very smart at this point.
About 6 minutes remaining. They'll work it around the arc. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Cross court.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
He goes up with it and score it.
Look at that spacing.
He puts up the tray.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
About 5 minutes remaining. Now they work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Two with a lay-in. He puts up the J. He misses the jumper. Cross court. turnaround jumper. Nope. Gave it up. Listen to the crowd. You can cut the intensity with a knife.
The man is off the charts, Brad.
And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Bad decision there by the senior.
Now looking to attack. Tries for two. Rims out. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from downtown and come up short. On the left side. Gave it up. With a block. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Let's take another look at this deep three.
Left side, get through that screen.
The Cavaliers move into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Moving it around the perimeter.
There's the trap.
Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. Let it go, and he missed. Lays it up. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside, and everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts, you can run screens, you can run back screens, you can do a lot of things on a perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town and throughout the campus come and enjoy themselves at these games.
They just have to focus, Brad. That's most important, mental toughness.
Sinks the shot.
Up and inside.
For two. Not this time.
Hey, Brad, this youngster is showing how to put the clamp on a player defensively.
Spectacular defensive effort. They work it around the perimeter. With the J. Nails the jumper. We're at the 1 minute mark. From the corner. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Paul taking it hard to the hoop. What a great take there.
Hey, when you can finish above the rim, you've got nothing to worry about, my friend. You should always throw it down when you have the chance.
On your left, jump, left side.
Ball's coming from the sideline.
Screen, get through the screen.
This one's coming in from the baseline. Into their zone motion now. Goes up for two. The shot's off to his shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
He drains the bucket. It might be safe just to start that bus up. I think this one's over.
That's all she wrote, Brad. This one is a done deal.
That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
Can't seem to find the stroke from the arc, Dick.
And they're missing wide-open looks too, Brad.
Well, we've got a moment here, Dick. Let's take a look at our players of the game.
Hey, two great young players here. Both stepped up for their teams and made this game interesting.